crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Zelbel. In this video, I want to purchase and set up an M2 Pro multi-token miner from MatchX. This device works as a node in a decentralized IoT network for the Internet of Things traffic. You can read all about this project on mxc.org. There are explanations. They're talking about their token, and they're also talking about this hardware. Let me give you one warning. Many people look at this kind of miners as money printing machines, but they are not. I think right now it is lucrative to operate these machines, but tomorrow the token price of the token that I get can collapse. There are so many different reasons why this token can collapse, and then my investment and everything I've earned is lost, just like that. There is nobody who owes me anything. If I could not live with this loss, then I would not purchase this miner because it is expensive. So let's get cracking and let's have a look how expensive it actually is. I go to matchx.io and then I select M2 Pro Miner. Then I scroll down and click on Start Mining. This puts such a miner into my cart. In the country selection, I select European Union because I'm in Germany. And that brings me to 2,100 euro plus VAT. Okay, I click Buy It Now. I have to log into my account. I don't have an account yet, so I have to go to create your account. And then I will go through the account creation process. I'm not going to film that, but I will create my account now. I activated my account. I don't have any orders yet, but I have something in my cart. So let's go to checkout. One important thing is that I can enter a discount code, and I found a code on their website. I will paste it in here and apply. I'm not going to show the code in the video because I don't know if it's still valid when you watch the video, but I will try to give you a code or a link below the YouTube video. If you use that code, then you should get the same discount. Over here, I got 50 bucks off my total, which is fantastic. The only shipping method that I can choose is UPS, but that's really good. So I can continue to payment and then just go through the payment process. I'm not going to film that, but I will just complete the payment with my credit card. I went through the purchase process. My order is complete. And now I'm waiting for the miner to arrive. It's now 23 days later and I just received my M2 Pro. That's a delivery time of just above 3 weeks, which I think is fantastic. I unpacked the device and I screwed the antennas onto the device. But the very first thing I would like to do now is installing the M2 Pro app on my Android. Let me bring the screen of my Android into the video. The M2 Pro came with an instruction manual, and in this manual is a QR code, which should lead me to the app. So I will start the camera app of my phone, go over the QR code and visit this URL. That brings me to the Google Play Store. I click on install. And it's installing the DataDash app. I can open the DataDash app. And because I don't have an account yet, I will click on sign up. Now I have to choose a super node. I can click on the plus, and since I'm in Germany, I will select Europe and select the MatchX super node. And then I have to provide my email address. I will do that and create an account with my email and a password, but I'm not going to film that. Okay, I created an account, and the first thing that the app asks me to do is adding a miner. And for that, I can scan the QR code on the M2 Pro device. I opened the front panel of the M2 Pro and I connected it to power. I didn't connect it to my Ethernet because I don't have a router anywhere nearby, but it gets power. That's why the LED is shining. It's currently red because it doesn't have any connection to the internet. But the interesting thing over here is that it has a label with a QR code and a serial number. And I need this QR code if I want to add this gateway by scanning it. So let's go back to the app and scan this QR code. I tap on plus. And it already found the QR code within a millisecond and says, congratulations. It's really awesome. I guess I'm done over here for now. Now I would like to give the M2 Pro access to my Wi-Fi. For that, I will change the Wi-Fi that my laptop is connected to a local Wi-Fi that the M2 Pro device is actually opening up. So let's join this Wi-Fi for the moment. And joining its local Wi-Fi network should allow me to connect to the administration interface of this device. My laptop is connected. Now let's open a web browser again. The address that I now access is the serial number of the device followed by .local. Let's try that. This is a login. The username is always admin and the password is again the serial number of the device, which I got from the sticker behind the front panel. So fill in the password and click login. It tells me to change my password. That makes good sense. Let's give it a new, really complex password and click apply. Good. This worked. Let's go to network and to wireless. I disable access point and I enable Wi-Fi client. Now I will fill the name of my Wi-Fi network into Wi-Fi SSID. I enable WPA as my Wi-Fi security and fill in my Wi-Fi password. That should be it. I click save. I can close this. I go to the system page. Over here is a link to the system page. And I click on reboot. Then on proceed. And now the gateway is rebooting. Now I relocate the M2 Pro. I set it up in our attic as high as possible, right under the roof. I installed a power socket over there so I can connect gateways like this one to power. There's also a little shelf over there where I can place power adapters and stuff like that. And the M2 Pro is my first gateway over there. I hope that the reception over there is as good as possible. But this is still something I have to try out and analyze, especially with other types of gateways where the reception is more important than with the M2 Pro. With the device set up over there, I will go back to the data dash up and check what it says. Over there, I tap on miner. Let me scroll down a little bit. It says offline. Okay. Let me refresh this thing. Maybe it just needs a refresh. Yes. Now it says online. The uptime is already 5% after the first couple of minutes. It looks like all is fine. I'm going to check back in a week and see if everything is still running smoothly. My M2 Pro has been running for about 1 week now. When I have a look in the Data Dash app, then it says it's 155 hours. Well, 1 week would have 168 hours, but it's practically 1 week. The uptime over here is shown as 100%. That's fantastic. And the health score increased from the initial value of 80% to 100% now, and it stays like that. It earned 909 MXC. Well, how much is that worth? Why don't I go to coinmarketcap.com? Over there, I can search for the MXC token and I can use their calculator. 909 MXC tokens is €67.16. Let's also check the value in US dollars just for fun. I can change the currency in the header of CoinMarketCap. And then I see it's $73.40. Well, I'm quite happy with that. However, the really interesting moment will be in about 1 year from now. Then I will check back and see what I actually earned in that year. And that will be a function of the token price by that time. So let's say at the end of the next 1 year period, the price of MXC goes up, then my tokens will be worth a lot and I will have a nice profit. But just in case at the end of the next 1 year period, the price goes down quite a bit, then I might not even be in the break-even zone. That could also happen, but I'm quite optimistic. Let me know how you see that. Let me also know if I could make something better, if you've got tips how I can optimize my earnings, or if you think I can make something better with this kind of gateways in general. In any case, I would be very happy to see you in the next video.